Hi, Mark Renz here with University of Wisconsin Extension. As promised, we're shooting some additional footage on how to identify pigweeds when they're flowering or have inflorescences present. Right now I'm standing in front of red root pigweed. This one's easily identified as red root pigweed because, again, it has hairs on the stems and also has this very distinct inflorescence. There are many branches or terminals to this inflorescence, but as you can see on this inflorescence, they are highly, highly compressed along here too, forming this cone-like inflorescence. Now, smooth pigweed is very similar to red root pigweed, as I have in my hands here. It also does have hairs on the stem and does have a fairly compressed inflorescence, but you can see they're a little bit more elongated in contrast to red root pigweed here too. So that's a really easy way to differentiate these pigweeds from our other pigweeds, which we're going to look at in a second. These also have male and female flowers on this inflorescence together, whereas waterhemp and palmer, which we're going to talk about in a bit, have separate plants that have female flowers and male flowers, and that can be another characteristic to differentiate among those pigweeds. So in contrast, waterhemp can look quite a bit different, as you see here, when it's flowering. But first off, a reminder is there are no hairs present on the stem, and that's a real key identifying characteristic to differentiate it from our other pigweeds. As you can see, this has much more spread out inflorescences, and there's many inflorescences that occur fairly loosely, and it's been termed wiry along the stem. It sometimes can have a main inflorescence that can get a bit long, but you'll see these laterals do pop up that show and are present. This one in particular tends to be red in color. It can be green or pinkish or somewhere intermediate in between those. So those are all good characteristics to differentiate water hemp from some of our other pigweeds. Also remember that when we look at the leaf will not have petioles that will exceed the length of the leaf blade. So that's another good characteristic in differentiating water hemp from Palmer Amaranth. Palmer Amaranth, like water hemp, has smooth stems with no hairs present on that stem, but their inflorescences are also quite unique. As you can see here, this inflorescence, the main terminal is around a foot tall right now. It'll grow probably another 6+ inches throughout the rest of the summer. And these lateral inflorescences that we see here in branchings will get 6+ inches long as well, much longer than we see in water hemp. Also, another differentiating characteristic is if you look at the leaf and you fold that petiole over the leaf blade, that petiole on mature leaves is much longer than that leaf blade. Final characteristic I want to point out is there's separate female and male plants. The female plants actually have very stiff bracts present that, as this matures, will actually hurt when you grasp it on the stem. This is not a good identifying characteristic, however, because the male plants do not have those stiff bracts, so you may not correctly identify that in the field. So we don't always rely on that as a good characteristic. We have lots of resources in addition to this video available on our website, so check in the links below or go to our Wisconsin First Detectors Network and search for Report a Pigweed, and you can find a lot of our other videos, handouts, and fact sheets about how to differentiate between these pigweeds, and our hope is that we can prevent the further spread of these throughout the state of Wisconsin. Thanks and have a good day.